Yo, what's up, everybody? How y'all doing up there? This is Jonah, y'all, and I'm back here with another video. And on this video, and I'm going to discuss about don't mess up your credit and your records, okay? And I'm just advising y'all people, and I'm just go ahead, just, you know, do the videos to encourage some people about, you know, don't mess up your credit. And also, I'm going to share things with you all about type of stuff, you know. And first thing is this. If you are the person don't care about your life, this video is not for you. If you are the person don't care about your credit and your record, this video is not for you. If you are the person don't even care about the truth at all, this video is not for you. If you are the person claiming yourself you're walking with God and you hate the truth, this video is not for you. If you are the person judging my videos, this message is not for you. If you are the person scared to go up higher and higher in your walks with God, this video is not for you. If you're not spiritual, don't have no understanding, don't have no common sense, this video and this message is not for you. If you are the person make jokes in my videos, this message is not for you. Now, Jonah going to share things with you all about, you know, about credit. And also, Jonah going to talk about don't mess up your credit, okay? Now, and I know majority of y'all got a good credit, and I know other y'all got a bad credit. So I'm gonna go ahead and just start with good credit. I know majority of people listen to my videos, those who got a good credit, man. I just want to say like this, man, God bless you, man. All right? I don't care who you are. I don't care you're black or white. I don't care you're male or female. I don't care who you are, man. I just want to say like this, man, God bless you. And also, keep your good credit. Keep your good record. Don't mess up, man. All right? And I'm just being real. I'm just keeping real. Keep a gutter, man. Keep a record clean. Keep your credit clean. Okay? Because then it makes you grow. It makes you, you know, to keep you not to do some stupid stuff. I'm just being real, man. Okay? Don't mess up. Don't mess up, man. You know? You got a blessing. God bless you. All right? God will bless you because you got a good credit. Just keep it that way. Don't mess up. Okay? Now, first thing this, y'all, if y'all had a good credit, you're able to buy guns, okay? And I just want to advise y'all, don't get one in the street. Don't do it, man. Don't do it because it's going to be on your record, all right? Don't buy guns on the street. Don't, you know what I'm saying? Don't buy it for somebody, okay? You got to buy a legal gun at the law company, you know what I'm saying? You know, y'all know what exactly what I'm saying, y'all, because, you know, if you got a good credit and good records are like 1000% clean, you have a legal right to get your weapon, okay? And don't forget to get your license and a membership card, okay? And I'm going to go ahead and just tell you something else, okay? If you get your gun, make sure you're doing it in the right way, okay? You gotta do it in the right way. Don't be around kids carrying a gun like that. Don't do it. You got to use your common sense, use your wisdom and knowledge, okay? Because God give us a wisdom and knowledge, okay? If you some of y'all, I know a lot of y'all, majority of y'all people got a gun already, and I just want to say you this, man. Keep your good record. Keep it clean, okay? Keep it clean all times, okay? Don't show your gun to your kids, man. Don't do it, okay? Don't do it. Keep your gun in your pocket all times. Before you go outside, make sure you keep it in your pocket because you don't want nobody to see it, okay? You got to bring your license, the membership card, everywhere you go because you don't want to be in jail, okay? Because I'm going to think about giving me one, but I don't know when I'm going to get it. But you know what I'm saying? So, and that's all I got to be saying, man. And I know a lot of y'all people got a bad record. You know, some of y'all commit felonies. Some of y'all been in the jail before in the past, been in the prison before in the past. Some of y'all got a bad credit. You owe a lot of people money. You owe the bank some money. You owe other people some money. And I just gonna tell y'all this, man. You're not able to get anything, okay? And I gotta keep it real with y'all, okay? So, you know what I mean? You can get mad, angry all you want to, and I gotta keep it real, y'all. You're not able to get anything, all right? Reason why I'm saying that, because you mess up your life. You mess up your calling in your walks with God in your life. You mess up, man. Whatever y'all be doing, man, you mess it up, man. You know what I'm saying? Your record was bad. You know, some of y'all killed people. Some of y'all killed people in the past. Some of y'all doing drugs. Some of y'all do marijuana. Some of y'all doing stuff in the past. And I got to say this. I got to be real, man. You're not able to get anything, y'all. Okay, you can try to get a job if you want to. I guarantee, okay? I'm guaranteed they're not going to sell you because you got a bad credit. And I'm just being real honest, okay? You can try to get a house. You can try to get a car. You could try, you know what I'm saying? And I'm just being real honest, okay? Don't get mad at me. I'm just speak truth. I'm not here to judge nobody. I'm just speak the truth, okay? You know what I mean? You could try to get an apartment if you want to. You're trying to, you know what I mean? You can try to put them on Section A. Or probably housing or something. You can try. And then I'm just being real honest. I'm just letting you know. They're not going to accept you. They're not going to accept you unless you go to the court, whatever you go to owe the people some money. Or, you know what I mean, to clear your record, to clear your credit and all this and that. But I'm just being real honest. And I was you. If I had a bad credit and a bad record, I got to do something. I got to save up my money, save up my stash, and start clear my name, you know, clear my record, and you know, clear my credit, you know. And I know a lot of y'all people don't care about your credit and your record. Hey, that's on y'all, you know. Y'all reaping what you sow, and I'm just being real, man. I'm just being real. So, like I said, I'm just telling y'all, you're not able to get anything. You can't get an apartment. You can't get a job. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You could get on exercise, but you're not able to get an apartment. And I'm just being real honest. All right. So and all of a sudden, you're not able to get no guns. You're not able to get anything because of your record. And I'm just being truthful about that, okay? You know, so and leave that alone, man. And I'm going to share things with you about I'm owing people some money. And God want me to share things with you all, okay? And because, you know me, I feel blessed, y'all. I feel blessed. And I'm about to share things with you all right now. And I wake up this morning and I start praying, you know. And I call the people up, or collect agency, and that's the one I owe, okay? They own the apartment in San Antonio, Texas, and I called a collect agency in Dallas, Texas, okay? And I told I'd like to make the payment how much I owe y'all, and they telling me, I say I owe them $386, so I give them a payment, you know, give them my credit card number and all this and that, you see what I'm saying? And I crested them and tell them, I said, after I owe you some money, how long gonna be clearing my credit? Cause they say it's gonna take for 30 days to clear my credit. Okay, so you know what I mean, it's to me it's kinda a little longer. It took for like 3 weeks to clear my credit. So I say, man, that's too long, but I'm not going to be that mad, though. I'm not mad, so I just had to be patient, you know what I'm saying? And I just had to wait to clear my credit because I able to give me another apartment. So I just sitting there and wait, because I just wait. I read up, people just send me an email and all this and that. Your credit was clean. Then you get your other apartment, you know what I'm saying? So, and I'm just being real honest, but I'm still feel blessed, man. God bless me because I owe people some money, you know what I'm saying? see, you know, I got to do it the right way. I got to do what I need to do, you know what I'm saying? Because I reaping with my soul. But I didn't know I owed people some money. I did not know, you know what I'm saying? Because I was in San Antonio, and I moved out of Landon. I'm at Ghostville apartment, and I moved to another apartment. They not send me no mail. I don't remember people calling me, talk about, Jonah, you owe people some money and all this and that. I don't even remember. You know what I'm saying? If I remember right now, if I was in Texas, if I remember, I should have been owed them some money. You know what I'm saying? But now, God was dealing me about, you got to owe people some money. You know, you got to do this, you got to do that. Then you get your apartment. So, and but now, and I know my answer, they say, Jonah, you owe people $386 because you didn't give people money to move out or something. So now I say, damn, man. So I already paid them some money. So, and I just feel blessed, you know what I mean? And I got to be honest with you all, and I'm going to tell you more truth. I got to owe banks some money too. I got to owe them $200. And I'm going to do it next month, you know what I'm saying? I got to do what I need to do, you know what I'm saying? That's reaping what my soul. I reaping with my soul, you know what I mean? And you know, God will bless me because I owe people some money. I got to do what I need to do because I'm not like other people in the world. I'm not like other people saying that I ain't owe them nothing. I'm not like other people, you know what I'm saying? Because I mess up, you know what I mean? I look at myself, what I did, I said, damn, man, I'm messing up. I got to do something. I got to owe people some money because I don't want my credit be bad. I don't want my records being bad, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, the guy, I have a guy named Sizzles. He from Louisiana. He helped me out with life insurance for my son, you know. But he telling me, you know, he look at my records every day. He told me my record was clean, okay? I'm just thank God my record was clean. So, you know what I mean? That means I don't need to be worried about owe other them some money by my record. You know, I never been locked up before, but I got handcuffs before, but I never been locked up, you know, and I never been to crimes. I never did nothing to hurt people. I never committed felonies. I never got evicted before, so I'm good, man. I'm just thank God, man, to lift me up. You see what I'm saying? I'm just thank God for lifting me up, man, because I feel blessed, man, you know, and you know what I mean? One of my brothers, man, in my family, they mess it up mentally, man. My family are messed up mentally, except for me, man, you know. And I don't have a bad record, but the truth is I have a little bad credit. It's the apartment and the bank, and that's it. Just two things, apartment and in a bank. I mess up two. That's two ways, man. That's two ways. That's the part when I mess up. That means I got to take care of both. But I already owe people some money. I already did. So I just feel blessed. So I got to wait for 30 days to clear my credit and say I can give me another apartment. You know what I'm saying? Right now what I'm in a motel apartment. I'm in a motel. And you know, I already told you guys in other videos, I'm not going to be here in the motel the rest of my life like other people. They got some people living the hotel the rest of their life, man. Because people ain't got nowhere to go. People got a bad credit, you know what I'm saying? And people just live in a hotel because majority of homeless people, they receive SSI just like I am. You know, me and my old lady receive SSI. And most people just pay $700 a month for a room. And me, I'm the main one paid $375. See what I'm saying? I'm the main one paid $375, man. I just feel blessed, man. You know what I'm saying? You know? I said, man, I don't need to worry about being broke because I still got more money in my pocket I could spend to buy something else. You know what I'm saying? The other people, man, the landlord, they charge them $700 for one bedroom, man. That's crazy, man. $700, man. Except for me and my girl, man, because I feel blessed, man. You know what I mean? I paid $50. She paid $50. You know what I mean? She paid $50 and I paid $50. Matter of fact, my baby mama, she didn't need to pay anything. I pay the rent myself. I pay the rent myself, man. I did it all myself. $375 ain't no bad deal. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no bad deal, man. I'm the main one paid, you know what I'm saying? Except for this rest of the people, man. People pay like $600, $700 a month rooms, man. That's crazy, man. I feel sorry for them, but damn, man. You know? And you know what I mean? The motel, when I'm at, this kind of poor ground for people. They had low income. You know what I mean? The people got receipt SSI. You know what I mean? The landlord at the motel office that said homeless, that said people with SSI. You know, that's for people who got a bad credit, people in parole. But I'm not on parole because I've never been in prison before. You see what I'm saying? So I'm good. I feel blessed, man. I feel blessed all the time, though. So now I need more blessing because I got to owe people some money. I gotta do what I need to do because I'm not like other people. Because I'm different than everybody, you know what I'm saying? And I'm trying to get my mama to understand, but she is tripping. My mama is tripping, so now I got to do what I need to do, man. I got to do what's right. I got to owe bank money. I got to do what I need to do, man, because God going to bless me even more, man. God going to bless me even more, man. You know what I'm saying? You know? That's right, man. If I get me an apartment, man, if I wait for 30 days, the 30 days is over, get my apartment, get my son back to get my life back. You know what I'm saying? Hell with my baby mama, wicked ass sisters out there in New Orleans, in Augusta, Georgia. Say, man, F them, man. But I still love them. You know, I always pray for them. You know, I hope they'll give their life to Christ. You know what I'm saying? I always forgive them. But they ain't got no right to brainwash my son, talk about your daddy's a beat and all that stuff, though. You know what I'm saying? They lucky I should have put his ass in the court. You see what I'm saying? But anyway. And I just want to share things with you all about I owe people some money. I already did already. They gave me that Parnation number already. So I'm good, man. So I just wait for 30 days to clear my credit, you know. Then I'm able to get an apartment out here. But I'm not going to tell everybody my address because I know my enemy's going to do, man. You know how enemies do. They're going to find you. They're going to kick in your door and start do some crazy. I got enemies in New Orleans, in Texas, and even Georgia and New York. I got enemies all over now. You see what I'm saying? That's the reason why I don't give nobody no address. Now, my mama's going to be my new enemy, too. See what I'm saying? And y'all do the same thing, man. If y'all move to another apartment, don't give nobody your address, man. Don't do it, man. You better use your common sense and sharpen your pencil. Don't give nobody your address. Don't do it, man. Especially people you don't give along. Don't give nobody your address. Don't do it, man. So I gotta be saved, man. You know, the another month I gotta do, I gotta owe bank some money. I gotta owe Bank of America $256. You know what I'm saying? It ain't bad. You know, I gotta do what's due, man. I gotta do what I need to do. I gotta do what's right because I feel more blessed. God will bless me more. After I done do what I do, what God called me to be, and God will bless me even more. I don't care what people are going to say. And I'm just doing what's right. That's what I'm doing. I'm doing what's right. See, other people in the street, they're not doing right. You know, they're not doing right. They messed their lives up, you know. And I see why people be homeless, you know. Some of your questions say, well, Jason, why are people homeless? Why are people living on the street? I'm glad you asked. Reason why people live in the street, because they choose to live in the street. You know, they choose living on the street. They ain't think about clear the record. You know why? What is that, Jason? Because they can't afford it to clear the record like I am. They can't afford it, but they just don't want to do it. That's the reason why people being homeless, you know, because homeless people, they be in the jail back in the day for crime, rape, marijuana, commit felonies, victim notice, and all this and that. That's the reason why a majority of homeless out here in California sleeping on the street. See, Los Angeles, man, I've been in Los Angeles. I feel bad for the people, man, because people that mess up their lives left and right, man. People just messed up their lives, and you know what I mean? People just came out of prison, all this and that. You know what I mean? That's why people homeless, man, because people doing drugs back in the day. People doing crimes back in the day, people gangbang back in the days and all this and that, you know what I'm saying? And that's the reason why people homeless, that's the reason why people sleeping on the streets, because they cannot get apartment, they can't get them jobs, they can't do anything because of their record. And that's the reason why people cannot be blessed by God. You know, because I know the way the way I look at things, what God showed me is, man, and I see why a lot of people on the street never get blessed by God because their record was bad. That's right, man. I'm just keeping it real, y'all. I don't care what people say, man. Because, you know, because I don't want to be like other people, man. Because I used to be homeless, too. I be homeless since 2013, man. And guess what? I keep it moving. I'm not going to sit in there and be in the street drinking a beer and doing drugs and all that stuff. I'm not seeing myself and sitting there and doing something. Guess what? I'm the main one make a move, man. I'm the main one make a move and do something, man. See, I move fast. I can't keep still. I move around too much, man. I'm trying to survive. I'm trying to find me a place to lay my head. See, I move around. I'm not like other people sitting there and do nothing. I'm the main one do something. Me and my friend do something. I say, man, I'm not going to sit in there to be in the street rest of my life, man. I got to do something, man. I make a move. I'm the main one making move, do something about my life, man. You know what I'm saying? I am not like other people and sitting there and do nothing for themselves. I'm the main one do something about my life, man. I keep moving, man. Guess what? All the old people some money, and I just feel blessed, y'all. You see what I'm saying? And that's the reason why I'm doing videos to encourage y'all. Don't mess up your record and your credit, man. Them really helps you grow up with God, man. God wants you to have a good credit and good record. Don't mess up. Don't mess up, man. Don't do it. Don't let Satan get into your soul, wants you to do some stupid stuff, man. Don't mess up, man. Don't do it, man. Don't do it to yourselves, man. You know what I mean? Don't do it to yourselves. Don't do it, man. Don't mess yourself up. You got to love. If you love your life, don't mess up your record and your credit, man. I'm telling y'all, man. I'm just being real honest with y'all, man. And that's all I got to be say, man. This is JC, y'all. And I'm just hit y'all with some truth. And I'm just want to share things with you all about, you know, I owe people some money and all this and that, man, you know. And that's all I got to be saying, man. This is Jonah, y'all. I'm out, y'all. Y'all be cool. Peace.